reason of the Lord God's sentence to Mary. Dear Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The Lord is the handmaid of the Lord. Dear Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The Lord is my church. Dear Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Christ, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Dear Christ, we beseech your Lord, thy grace, sins, and grace. Pray to the meantime, Lord, you have Christ, your Son, as we have known you by the mercy of the angels. May God his flesh and flesh be glad to take glory to the resurrection, to the Son of Christ, to the Lord. in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I welcome all of you to the celebration of the gospel in the beautiful sign of our Lord Jesus. So, those of you who are pilgrims today, or those who have come from the village and the village is round about, and to all those of you who are joining us by processing EWTN in live streaming. A very happy feast day to you. Because today we celebrate the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, body and soul into heaven. As the first disciple of the Son Jesus Christ, she was the first to share in his resurrection glory in the life of God. She is our hope, the hope of the Church, that we may have been controlled to God. So we seek her prayers as we seek to follow the example of obedience and faithfulness. Let us also prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries of acknowledgement and sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, as I have truly said, in my prayers and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, in my thoughts, in my prayer, in my most dearly church, I pray the highest blessed Mary and the Virgin, and the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to our enemies in the Lord, and to the Almighty God, to us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Thank you. Thank you.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, the celebration of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary is one in which the whole church rejoices. And in many countries across the world today, at this time, it is painted a particularly joyful with processions, bands, dances, food. The divine and the human blend in the one sublime celebration. And then to say that Christianity is the religion of the incarnation. We believe that the divine Son of God came to share in our humanity so that one day we human beings might share in his divinity. And more often this profound understanding of the divine exchange and its consequences for Christian understanding of our human nature, we see more clearly than what we believe about the Assumption of our labor. First, at the beginning of her life, the moment of her conception, God chooses Mary to be the mother of his Son, and himself with his grace. And after God has made known his choice to her, and she has sent his word to her, she visits her cousin Elizabeth. The cousin hears her with these words, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. This blessed is she who believes the promise made to her by the Lord would be fulfilled." God loves and cherishes Mary all the way through her life. She is indeed precious in his sight. Our Savior's forgiveness today reminds us of the sacred nature of all human life. It is God who brings us into being. It is God who chooses us to be his children. And fills us with his grace at the moment of our baptism. Like Mary, he has created us to do some definite service to St. John the Unbelieving Tortoise. He has not created us for nothing. And then she runs our lives and continues to lavish his love upon us and cherishes us and instigates us to discover his plan for us and to carry it out. And you and I, too, are precious in the Lord's sight. Also, continue from the work of the conception, Mary already shared in the fruits of the grace that could be poured out into the world through the death and resurrection of her Son, freedom from sin, and this consequence, eternal death. So at the end of her life, God takes Mary, body and soul, to be with him in the heavenly glory, to be the first to share in the resurrection of our Son and Lord, Jesus Christ. The Lord loves and cherishes His name, not just to write a life of earth, but also to render it for obedience and faith and love, the generosity and constancy by the wording. Her vocation has a destiny. Our celebration today reminds us of the nobility of our human nature. It has a destiny. The human life is not a result of chance. Through our baptism, we see that we are able to share in the redemption from sin and death that Jesus achieved for us on His cross and the resurrection. The possibility of being drawn into the eternal life of God, the life of the bodies being transformed into the likeness of the Lord's own glorious living body, becomes a reality for us. Jesus assures us, I am now going to prepare a place for you. It is important for us to share this beautiful gift from God, this beautiful truth. Today we live in a society that does not seem to have any perception of having been brought into existence by God for a purpose and for an eternal destiny. This can be seen in society's attitude today. God's unborn life in the womb, it can be discarded at just any moment. It can be seen in its attitude towards the elderly, who seemingly no longer beautiful, no longer able to contribute to society, are increasingly seen to be disposable and to be encouraged to consider assisting suicide. Our Lord's assumption. God shows us that all human life has a purpose. All human life has a vocation. And all human life has an eternal destiny in the glory of heaven. So as we celebrate Mary's ascension into heaven, and celebrate at last Mary's resurrection day, we celebrate our hope that the great things God has done for Mary are the great things that He will do for all His sons followers for the very church. Amen. I'm going to go to the next one.
and
Do not accept me to go and be a message. and Jesus declares to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The it may be always increasing in strength behind its face, as we are going to go through the faith in the coming of our Savior and Jesus Christ. Spiritual describes the sexual attention. Peace shall we be my peace shall give me. Witness of our sins, but in the faith of your church. The grace of the presence of peace and joy in accordance with your will, the living Lord, forever and ever. Peace of the Lord to give you all the business.
Just
Having received the sacraments of salvation, it asks you to grant your Lord, the true intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you ascended into heaven, and that you grant to the glory of the resurrection, in Christ our Lord. If you might just want to say a few words about this afternoon, but just for I just like to welcome my brother priests and deacons who are here today. Two priests who have joined us from France, others who are very welcome. I'm really with a priest from Solemnity, from Boston, in Lincolnshire. So I'm trying to be attractive and talk to the various priests there. But there's a deacon and a priest from Liverpool. Yes, and we've got a priest that's in the meantime, so and these two priests are working in the aspect and in the strong of the family, so special thing for them, please, in their name. And as we are very welcome. And those of you who have been working in Africa, who are your pilgrimage, you can say especially welcome, and it's been a pleasure to be here today.
I'm going to go to the next slide. Thank you.